kill them all. Oh, wrong button. This is what you did. This is what you did to save. Hey guys, Kevin here. He's a handsome man. This is Call of Cthulhu: Dark Corners of the Earth. I reviewed this recently for the site. This is me about 5 minutes into the game. I've been called to a mansion to investigate a bunch of cultists because apparently they're asking for me by name. Not long after I enter, they start shooting at the police. Yes. Yeah, this game came out back in, say, 2006. It was originally meant to be part of a trilogy, but that never quite worked out. I'll let you watch this scene.
Don't shoot.
Oh dear, the plot thickens.
Damn, he recognized me, and it sounded like he was going to get on the level with what's going on in this joint. A key. Could come in handy.
Yeah, the gameplay of this game is sort of interesting. It sort of changes from level to level. Right now it's sort of... it's quite basic, but... it's sort of like an adventure game tropes. You know, you have to find certain items, certain keys, you have to solve sort of mundane puzzles, but later on, you know, there's stealth, there's action. Oh, that's me. And things like that, yeah.
There are definitely some strange sounds coming from this side of the room.
This is based off the H.P. Lovecraft sort of Cthulhu mythos. Apparently this is... oh. I'm sort of speeding through this because I don't know what to do, but... sort of based off the Cthulhu mythos by H.P. Lovecraft. So you sort of know what to expect, you know, the whole private investigator going in and strange alien type scary powers. Oh, poor guy. All right. Oh, should have done that.
This tunnel feels like it's going to collapse at any moment.
Right, okay, there is something of a puzzle here, but I know what to do, so I'm just going to solve it quickly and just get on with it. This sort of crystal thing is a power supply, so I'm just going to take it, because he doesn't need it anymore.
The machine must have overloaded. He's dead.
Yeah, it was an accident. It overloaded, it wasn't me. Then you go down here. And you have to just put the crystals somewhere or wherever. And this pretty much ends the prologue. I'll watch a bit of this cutscene, but I won't watch the whole thing, I'll skip ahead. Yeah, but see, I've no control over this bit. This is, it's still in first person, but it's a complete cutscene. Alright, I just went ahead and skipped that for you. Brief overview of the story. It's about 6 years later after that happened, and your man, Jack Walters, wakes up with amnesia, as you do. He sort of went insane for a bit, and now he's left the Arkham Asylum, yes, that one. And he's just become a private investigator. I don't think the police are too keen on him anymore. So he's just been hired to go to the town of Innsmouth to find someone's missing son. Innsmouth, as you say. This is apparently what the short story that this is heavily based off, called Shadow over Innsmouth or something like that. I should probably have looked that up. So this is the part of the game that I like the most. The you arrive in this town and you're simply asked to do an investigation. You know, there's no real action-y stuff. There is later. So I'm just looking up. Yeah, Shadow over Innsmouth, I believe it's what it's called. It's the short story this is based off. Still part of the whole Cthulhu mythos, written by H.P. Lovecraft, all that jazz. And the reason I like this is because it just sort of leaves you to your own devices. It's not an open world, but it does just sort of leave you to figure out what to do for yourself. You'll see once we get out. And I quite like the tone. It's sort of silly, sort of dumb, but in a good way. You know, it's very clear from the get-go that there's something sinister going on. Like, this is a no one here is to be trusted. They make it very clear they don't like you, and it's very obvious that something bad's going to happen soon. I kind of like that. I just talked to a few people, including the bus driver.
Could you direct me to the First National grocery store? I hear they have a shop in town.
I don't know nothing about
that. Oh, well, you see, I'm looking for a young lad.
And also, I mentioned briefly in the review that everyone sort of looks like some sort of hideous monster. It's quite weird, but I quite like it. Jebediah Springfield. So yeah, you come here, and as you just said to the bus driver, you're looking for the First National grocery store, and it's quite interesting because you can see there's no compass, there's no waypoint. You just sort of have to figure out for yourself. It took me quite a while to figure out first. You probably saw in that cutscene, you saw a guy walking there, so I thought, huh, maybe that's something to do with it, but that's nothing to do with that at all. It may take you a while to find it. I know where it is because I've played this before. It's right there. But you know, it just you read up your notes, you try and figure out what to do. Let's see how this go. Whoa. See what I mean about the hideous monsters.
Excuse me, Jack Walters.
Rhodes. Alien Rhodes.
Yeah,
What do you
you.
want?
Could you help out a stranger to this fine port?
Are you being funny?
No. Not at all.
Oh, sorry.
I'm after directions to the First National. I hear they have a store in town.
Innsmouth don't take too highly to them.
See, everyone's just really keen to help out. Yeah, so obviously, the First National, you have to get in here. This is where the guy worked. You need to go in there and find some clues, like an actual detective. The front door's closed, so you should try and get in the side entrance. Be cautious sneaking past enemies. So this guy, if he finds you, he'll just sort of throw you out. You know, it's not quite, he won't attack you. He's not quite that bad, but the town just clearly doesn't like you. Doesn't want you to be here. It doesn't take kindly to strangers, as he said. You need to be careful, or else this hideous monster, who I think's just meant to be human, will grab you. Like I said, the first third of this game I'm really keen on. Just even when the action starts, about 2 or 3 hours in, the town finally, or spoilers, the town finally turns against you. But even then, you don't have any weapons. There's no way of fighting back. You just have to sneak about. You block doors so they can't get after you. You lock doors. You just run away from them and then start sneaking about. It's really good. I really like it. For me, the game really starts to fall apart a few hours in, once you actually get your guns, because then it focuses mostly on gunplay, and the gunplay is dreadful in this game.
Nothing of interest.
Wrong one. I mean, the game will every so often still say, "Oh, it's best to sneak about. It's best to remain undetected," but it's bullshit, to be perfectly frank. It's once you have the guns, it makes it very easy just to walk about and do whatever you want.
It's unlocked.
Oh yeah. And you're gonna get a slight peek at what the later on in the game is about. As I mentioned, once the town turns against you, this is the sort of thing you have to do. You have to block entrances so they can't get after you. And just really avoid combat. So now, we carry on our investigation. Oh. It's medical kits, but like I said, because there's no combat just now, medical kits aren't really that helpful. Again, I've played this before, so I know what to do. Oh! And if you stay here, if you don't figure out what to do fast enough, this guy finds you. He's kicking on the door, the policeman. Oh! I really like this bit. Also, a very interesting thing about the gameplay for this bit is that, as I mentioned earlier, oh, that's what I came here for. As I mentioned earlier, shut up. As I mentioned earlier, you don't really have a compass. There's no waypoint. The only way to figure out what to do is to actually look through your evidence. It's really interesting in that department. It actually forces you to actually investigate, actually figure it out for yourself.
It must have already been badly damaged on one side.
And while investigating, you find out about the backstory. It's just a really interesting way of doing it, and I wish the whole game was like this, to be frank. I really could do without the really bad action game that it eventually becomes. And this was interesting at the time. There's plenty of bullets lying about, but like I said, for the first few hours, no guns. But it really forces you to look at everything. And later on you'll have to use these deadbolts to escape bad guys. I'm quite OCD about closing doors. Oh, let's forget. Oh!
Hello, Jack. Do I know you?
Lucas Mackey. Sorry to startle. Innsmouth doesn't get a lot of visitors. New names spread fast. What are you doing in town, Jack? Hear about the missing Burnham boy?
Not bad. I'm a private detective. My client's a friend of the Burnhams.
Seen the latest press from Arkham? Your boy's been quite busy.
What about you, Mackie? You're obviously not a local. What's your business in town?
True enough, Jack. Nothing too exciting, I'm sorry to say. I'm a government factory inspector. They posted me in this rotten hole to check over the old Marsh refinery. Speaking of which, I've got an appointment with the manager, Jacob Marsh.
Okay, maybe I'll catch you later. That's the first friendly face I've seen in this damn town. But I've been in this business long enough to know he's hiding something.
So yeah, it doesn't explicitly say what you have to do next. You have to look through your evidence, look through the diary you just found, to figure that out. So in that respect, it's quite interesting. Although, if it wasn't clear that something evil was going on here, here's a little cutscene for you. And some people talking about you behind your back. Let's just see what they've got to say.
I'm looking for Brian Burnham.
So yeah, it's hardly Grand Theft Auto, but it is a fairly open world. You're just sort of left to review the evidence and figure out what you're actually supposed to do.
Do you know the Burnham lad? He worked in the First National.
Can't quite say as I know it.
There is actually one time, it's a bit further on in the game, that I actually saw some hooded figure looking at me from above. Don't think we'll see it here. Better wrap up this video soon. But yeah, you can just sort of walk about and... Oh! I'll introduce you to her first.
Evening. name's Jack Walters. It's a pleasure to meet you, miss.
Miss will do for now. Welcome to Innsmouth, Mr. Walters.
Thanks, I think.
Take my advice. Do what you must and then leave. Tonight, this port does not cater well to visitors.
Well, I appreciate your concern, miss. I can handle lousy hospitality.
Very well, Mr. Walters.
Yep, she may or may not become important later. So yeah, I think I'll wrap up this video for now.
Seems more open to some folks around these parts, but she isn't going to talk to me right now.
So yeah, this is a really cool game. My review's up on the site. It starts off really well, but then the ending just... If it wasn't for the fact I was reviewing this game, I would have stopped playing about 5 hours into it. So yeah, it's really interesting. Catch you later.